All right, let's see if he bites him or not. Go ahead. You said he bit him. And I don't know. He gets his finger in his mouth. It's an old one. That's why he got a little upset. It's an oldie.
Bergeron doesn't look upset.
No, I know. It's an oldie, but it's a goodie. He bit him because he's a hungry hockey player. Now, you think goalies aren't superstitious and a little nuts flaky? Watch Thomas here. There's no net. But he always hits, he always hits the post before he gets out. Now, watch this one. Watch this now. He's getting, watched all this nonsense. By the way, like, I'm getting out of here. Get out. You're not, like, watch him go like this. Nah, shut up. I'm getting out of here. Now, one other thing I want to.
Hold on, before you get into that, you did call the Vancouver Canucks came out storming, and obviously a couple of penalties throughout the rhythm of the attack they had going.
Big saves. I got to say something.
Yeah?
I got to say something. I wasn't going to, but you have to. The last game in Boston, no penalties, right? Did you see any of that nonsense? Did you see anything? Did you see guys diving like they are tonight? No. Because the guys know you do dive, they're not going to call it. And you didn't have nonsense like this because the referees let them play the game. All right, go ahead. What are you going to say?
You think they're coming on, the Bruins? Because my thought was Vancouver, after 8 days, they'd start to fade a little bit.
Bruins are coming on, but that power play is something. But first, I want to show you, could be, what do you call them, the struts or stanchions? This is a little funny in this building here. Watch, this is the first one. Comes right back out, but watch this second. If this Bruin is coming a little later, watch this one. Could be a big thing if that coming a little later.
Already has been.
Yeah, I know.
Here it is. Kevin Bieksa's, of course.
Well, yeah, Bieksa's the same thing. It's funny about those things there. Now, predictions. Let's see what I did.
No, hold it. We'll get to that in a minute, but here's another thing you're great on, and that is Char standing in front of the net.
Oh, you're going to do that. Okay, just a minute. Listen, everybody knows I insist that Chara shouldn't be in front of the net. And everybody says of his shot, it's good. But he doesn't play it good. You could be 6'11". Watch, he gets out of the way. As they're shooting, he gets out of the way. And he's trying to tip it in. He shouldn't be tipping it in. He should be he gets out of the way. He's trying to tip it in. Now I'm going to show you Holmstrom. Watch this here. You don't try to tip it in. Now watch this great shot. He just stands there. Boom. That's the way to do it. Stand there. Your job is not to tip it in, and he tips it off the net. Your job is to stand there and screen the goalie.
Quick thing on the big point shot by Char, or do you want to get
it? We've showed it. Who would you rather have on the point? Think of all their guys. Why not? This guy shoots at 105 miles an hour, and you got him standing in front of the net. Dumb.
Here we go. This was a Heritage Classic in Calgary when you called it again.
Yeah.
Atlanta may come to Canada. What do you think is going to happen?
You know, I got to tell you people, Atlanta, and I don't care what team it is, and I like to see Quebec they will eventually get a franchise. No doubt Quebec's going to get a new arena and everything, we'll pay for it. But that doesn't make any difference. They are going to, but I am guaranteeing you people in Winnipeg, I'm guaranteeing you will have a franchise there. It doesn't matter. The 15,000 people say, you know, the wise guy, you know, they know everything, you'll never be there. The 15,000 doesn't mean a thing because if you even had another two at the top, if they're all the cheap seats up there, it doesn't count anything. You will be there and you will get it. I guarantee it. I'm never wrong. And here's the guy, Mark Chipman, with David Thompson that got the Jets, so we call him for now. The Jets said, way to go, Mark.
Well, this is where you belong, Mark. You're a great hockey man and a great hockey family. I know your dad, Bob, was tickled at the press conference, and your mom, Sheila, would be so proud of what you've accomplished here and the kids. So tell us what it's been like the last 24 hours. Bring us up to date on what's been happening since the grand day yesterday.
Well, it's been really quite a ride, wide range of emotions, guys. Just the fact that I'm on Hockey Night in Canada tonight, I was saying to the technical guys here, your camera people, it's really bizarre. I ordinarily would just be watching Hockey Night in Canada. To be to talking to you guys tonight is just incredible.
How did you come to hockey? Because it's obvious you got Bobby Orr in behind you and can't do better than that. So was he your favorite player, and how did you come to the game?
Well, like most, I got a chance to play at a very early age, and at about the time Bobby started playing, and I was immediately drawn to him and the Bruins, and and you know, just followed his career, which unfortunately didn't last near as long as it should have. But I think just like most you know, young kids growing up, just learned to love the game at a very early age, and was fortunate enough to play it and you know, coach it, and still, you know, play with friends to this day on a regular basis. So I've just, you know, been fortunate to be a part of the game in a lot of different ways through most of my life.
It's so neat how you said, well, we didn't have a team, we got to have a team. So you've got the Manitoba Moose, we didn't have a rink, we got to have a rink. So you got the MTS Center.
I mean, that's the question.
Good. Are you going? I had this sweater. This was given to me. See what it said? And you can see I wore it ever since, and lifting weights with it. They're coming back. Now, the question I asked you is, are you going to name them the Jets or what?
We've been getting that question a lot in the last few days, and we haven't made that decision just yet. We certainly haven't ruled it out, but we've been so focused, guys, on just getting this transaction done, and we had to do it in a very, very short period of time. I think, as was reported yesterday, we just got it done just sort of under the wire before that press conference yesterday. So we've turned our attention to that, and we'll make a decision on that real soon.
We'll let you have that one, Mark, but this one's a biggie.
This is a biggie. Now, I asked to have you on. I was the guy to ask you to have you on. And now this is a question. What are you going to do with the Queen? That's what I want to know right now.
No plans for the Queen, with all due respect to the monarchy, Don. I think the Queen is actually closer to you right now. I believe she's in Whitby, Ontario. At least that's what I'm told. And I'm also told I don't think they would actually fit back in our building. So, again, with all due respect to the monarchy and their loyalists, I don't see the Queen in our future.
Can't even have her in the hall, eh? The old thing, English,
well,
is down the drain.
That's tough. Mark, Grapes will be out there next October. If he happens to sneak up in the back stairwell, we'll understand it. We get a lit picture of Her Majesty there for you. Listen, congratulations. You call him what you want. You got it, Pontiac. You'll understand what I mean by that. You did a great job. Well done.
And
thank
now
you very much,
I
guys.
Hope we never have to do this one again. And we're having fun in the finals, but again, we've lost a great guy, Bombardier Carl Manning, the Valcaire, Quebec. That was his base. The 1st Battalion, Royal 22nd, a great. They were there when I was there. Battle group. He was in the battle group. He's from Chicoutimi, Quebec. You know, he just got engaged to Julie, his fiance, and they'd bought a house and they planned to marry. You know, our condolences to his mom and dad, Reg. You know, he was there for 6 months, and he only had a couple more weeks to go. Carl was 31. God bless you.